Hello, welcome to Scrap Time episode 988. My name is Christina and on today's episode I'm showing you the Tim Holtz Frameworks Honeycomb Die from Sizzix. Today I am showing you the Tim Holtz Frameworks Honeycomb Die from Sizzix. And I'm going to show you, I made this art journal page and all this texture is made with the honeycomb die. You can see that some of them are flat, some have a bit more texture on it, and some are even smoother. So I'm going to show you how I made this background. So what I did was I took a bit of grunge paper. Grunge paper is thinner than grunge board, but the great thing about the Sizzix thick dies is that you can cut so many different surfaces with it, including grunge paper, really easily. And I used multimedium and glued down one of my collage sheets. And on this collage sheet, I had put on some molding paste through a stencil. So that's how I get that extra texture on it. And then what you end up with are a bunch of these little honeycombs, hexagons, whatever you want to call them. So I have some that are cut on the grunge paper, and then I have some that are just the paper. And that's how I get the different levels in my book. So these are great. You can use them on so many different projects. You can use them like this with the little bits of color, but today we're actually going to be painting over top of them. You also end up with all of these little bits that you can use later to add texture to your project as well, really quickly. You can just lay them on. So here I have my card that I started working on, and you can see the pattern that I'm sort of making. And what I do is I use the leftover to help me sort of guide my pattern of where I'm placing my little honeycombs. And I'll do a little bit for you here just so you get the idea. Oops, way too much. So I know my next little hole will be there, so I sort of just put this in, put it in place, I hold it down and then I sort of lift it off and then let the glue stay. And this just helps guide where to place the little honeycombs. But of course you could do a completely different pattern and use them. You don't have to use them in this formation. You can just use them wherever you want on your projects. Put my next one down. I can put one over here. When I glued my collage sheet onto the grunge paper, I actually let it sit a while to dry before cutting it out, because if you cut it out too soon, all the paper may peel off your grunge paper. So if you know you're going to do it, maybe glue your paper down and then just let it dry for a while. I'll just finish this row and show you. I like to use the multimedium in these little bottles. I'm not sure if you can still get them since Ranger has discontinued the studio line. But if you can still buy these little bottles of multimedium, it just makes it so much easier when you're doing these little projects, smaller projects, where you're not covering a whole page of that in the medium. Now I cheat a little bit on this corner. I don't want it hanging off so much. So I put another line there. You can see how I formed that. So now all I need to do is just fill in this little area, and then I'm going to let it dry and we'll move on to our next step. So now all of my little hexagons or honeycombs have been glued down and dried. I'm going to put a layer of gesso. I'm using golden gesso, but you can use any gesso you like to use. And this is just to take down some of that color and bring it all to sort of the same base, because we're going to paint over top of this again. So even though I'm painting over that molding paste, it's still going to come through. The texture will still be there, which will make it a little more interesting as the final project. Now, of course, if you were doing this, you don't have to, because we're covering the collage paper, you don't have to use collage paper. You could just use the grunge board as is. The reason I used the collage paper was I just wanted the pieces with that modeling paste texture. But since we were actually covering all the painting, it's not necessary to use collage paper. So there, I've painted over that level or that layer. And now I'm just going to let this dry before I paint it with my color. So now I'm going to put my layer of paint down. I'm using some teal, and I'm just going to put it on my palette paper here. I don't need too much. I can always add more. I probably need more than that. And put my lid on. And then I'm going to use the Brilliant Yellow Green. You can see some of that color is still showing through. So if you don't like that, you may want to put more gesso over it all. Or use a heavy bodied paint. This blue is the golden artist colors, and you can see how much heavier it is than the green. And it covers up everything below it. So that's some difference too when you're looking at paints and how there's different prices in paints. You can see right there the basics, which is a lower end paint. You could see the color through, whereas this golden one, which cost a bit more, just completely covers anything that was there. Just trying to get it in all the little around the corners. I think I need a smidge more paint. I think since most of it's covered, I'm going to do the green. And just go over the blue a bit with some green. Just gives you a nice blend of color. So even though we've painted over it, that texture from that embossing paste or molding paste are still showing through. And now we have this nice even colored background, and I'm just going to dry it and then show you one more step. So I just want to finish it off with a bit of stamping. I'm using the Archival Ink in Black. And I have this little stamp. I think it was a Prima stamp. Ink it up a bit. And I like this little stamp just because I just want to stamp on some of the raised up hexagons. So I want to have control over my stamping. Some of these are the lower ones, so put a little stamping over there. And you can see I didn't ink up my stamp between all my stamping. There was enough ink on it to sort of get it around most of the card. And even a bit over some of that embossing paste. And just by adding this little bit of stamping, just adds a little bit more texture to the card, sort of like that. So that is one way of many, many ways you can use the Tim Holtz Frameworks dies. Well, that's it for today's episode. Be sure to check out our website at www.scraptime.ca. And on our next episode, I'm showing you the Hazel and Ruby Chalk Art Kit. So please join us. Thanks for watching Scrap Time.